الله أكبر الله أكبر. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه واتباعه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، Verily all praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek His aid and we ask for His forgiveness. And we seek refuge with Allah from the evils of ourselves and from the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, there is none who can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah misguides, there is none who can guide him. And I bear witness that none has a right to be worshipped except Allah alone, having no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is a slave and messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, his family, his companions, and all those who follow in their footsteps until the day of judgment. عباد الله، أو slaves of Allah، اتقوا الله، fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى، and give thanks to Him on account of the great favors that He has endowed upon you, including the completion of fasting and the voluntary night prayers, which are the greatest of all favors. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your deeds and to overlook your mistakes. For He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous of all those who show generosity and the most benevolent of those who show benevolence. Our hearts were filled with happiness, hope for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the fear for His retribution at the beginning of the great month that just passed, that just ended, the great month of Ramadan. We invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and our prayers, and to accept from us our past deeds, and to bless us the remaining part of our lives. Blessed is He whose sins were forgiven and whose repentance was accepted. Today, brothers and sisters in Islam, Eid al-Fitr, we thank Allah for His blessing of giving us Muslims the opportunity to fast and to have observed the night prayers during Ramadan, for making it possible for us, and we ask Him to save us from the punishment of the hellfire. Allahu Akbar, how quickly have the days and nights passed? So quick. Yesterday we were receiving Ramadan, and today we bid farewell to it. We say ma'a salam, and we do not know whether we are going to receive it again. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us have many more of Ramadan. Ikhwani wa akhawati, brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan has filled our minds with blessings. It has awakened our conscience and purified our souls. He who has benefited from Ramadan is the one whose condition after Ramadan becomes better than before. Doing good deeds after previous ones is a sign that those former ones have been accepted. Equally, going back to the evil deeds after having done the good deeds, the ibadat, is a sign of its invalidity and it being rejected. Therefore, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let the shining breezes of Ramadan be the very key to blessing all the time in your way of life. Endeavor, try hard to be kind to your parents and neighbors, to make visits to your brethren, to help the oppressed and the weak, to take care of the orphans, to make the afflicted Muslims happy, to be kind to your kith and your kin, to your relatives, to defend the honors of your brothers, and always be a source of good as you were in the month of Ramadan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, though we bade farewell to Ramadan, this should not mean ma'salam also to our acts of worship, to put a cup or an end to ibadat. Rather, the Muslim should strengthen the tie between himself and his Rabb so that he may have a perpetual, continuous blessing. As for those who break the covenant with the Rabb and abandon the masajid to leave the mark of the masjid as soon as Ramadan ends, such are evil people. Evil people who know the Rabb only in Ramadan, and afterwards they turn back on their heels. Remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily, my prayer, my sacrifice, my living, and my dying are all for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The Rabb, the cherisher, the sustainer of the world. There is no value of an act of worship by which one does not increase in piety and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No value, useless, but waste. Where is the impact of soul or fasting when one abandons the recitation of the Quran, no longer observes the fard salawat, forgets the five other prayers, and desecrates other people's honors? Where is the impact of his acts of worship in Ramadan when he afterwards eats usury or riba interest? Again, commenting the norm as a 5-6. It takes other people money wrongfully in the haram way. Where is it? Where is the impact of Ramadan when we abandon the path of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sunnah, for local adat, customs and traditions, and governs his life with man-made laws? Where is it? Where is the effect of fasting and the night prayers when one engages in acts of deception of his business transactions, cheats people, and lies day and night? What use is it? Where is the impact of Ramadan on him who does not follow the misled to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, feed the hungry, clothe the naked, and make a sincere supplication for Islam and the Muslims? About Allah, fellow worshippers, Allah does not need the movements and efforts that we make in our ibadah. He does not need it. He only requests our piety thereof. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All you who believe, fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you. For what reason? That you may have taqwa, power, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. He subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, لَيَّ نَعْمَ اللَّهَ مَحُومُهَا ولا دماؤها ولكن ينالوا التقوى منكم. It is neither their meat, their sacrifices, nor their blood that reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, it is the taqwa, the piety, that reaches He subhanahu wa ta'ala, that reaches Him. Brothers and sisters in Islam, of the good deeds that are recommended after Ramadan has passed, is the fasting of the 6 days Shawwal. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. He who fasts Ramadan and follows the Rabb with 6 from the upcoming month Shawwal, from the month of Shawwal, it will be in terms of the rewards as if he fasted the whole year. Allah, what great reward. Let us strive to earn it, inshallah ta'ala. The fasting Muslim, brothers and sisters in Islam, has 2 occasions of happiness. When he breaks his fast, and when he meets his Rabb. One is a worldly happiness. The other is the everlasting one, and the hereafter, when he will have the greatest of enjoyment and bliss, which is Jannah, paradise, in which there are enjoyments which no eyes have ever seen, no ears have ever heard, and no human mind has ever imagined. And where we shall be addressed thus, كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا أَسْلَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَةِ. Eat and drink at ease for which you have sent forth before you in the days past. وَتِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. This is the Jannah, this is the paradise which you have made to inherit because of your deeds which you used to do in this life, in this dunya. تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا. Such is the paradise, such is the Jannah, which we shall give as an inheritance to those of our slaves, of our ibad, who have been pious, religious, sticking to Islam. Brethren in faith, here are the people who are shown the banner of Jannah, the paradise. And they exerted all their efforts. The way to the blessed garden was made clear to them, and they stayed firm on it. They know that the real prophet lies in being gathered before the Lord, like a delegation for the eternal honor, and they were eventually made to enter the paradise. جنات عدن التي وعد الرحمن عباده بالغيب إنه كان وعده مأتيا. The everlasting gardens which the most gracious Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised his slaves in the unseen early. His promise must come to pass. It is the garden of everlasting growth, not by the gardens of this world. Allah has promised it to those who are pious, and His promise never fails. Such is a Jannah which, when a slave is made to enter it, he forgets his misery, his sadness, his distress, his sorrow, as it is reported in Sahih Muslim that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُكْتَى بِأَشَدِّ النَّاسِ بُؤْسًا فِي الدُّنْيَا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فَيُصْبَحُ صَبْرَةً فِي الْجَنَّةِ فَيُقَالُ لَهُ يَا ابْنَ آدَمَ هَلْ رَأَيْتَ بُؤْسًا تَطْرُ هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ شِدَّةٌ تَطْرُ فَيَقُولُ لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبُّ مَا مَرَّ بِي بُؤْسٌ تَطْرُ وَلَا رَأَيْتُ شِدَّةً تَطْرُ. The most unfortunate, the saddest of people, the most struck by distress and misery and sorrow. In this world, it's dunya, the one who has lived the worst in this life. Among the people of Jannah, will be given a short dip into paradise. Just a moment. A short dip into Jannah. And he will be asked, Ibn Adam, O man, have you ever known any misery? Have you ever experienced difficulty? He would say, La Allah, no, by Allah, I have never experienced any misery, nor experienced any difficulty. That is the worst amongst us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us the people of Jannah. Imagine with a similar dip, all his misery, all his hardships, all his trials, all his challenges that he has faced through Allah will have gone and disappeared. No memory at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Jannah a place of abode for his friends and filled it with mercy, honor and pleasure. He described his bliss as a great victory, filled it with all that is good, and purified it from all imperfections and evil. The floor of Jannah is made of musk and saffron. Its ceiling is under the mighty throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Its gravel is pearl, coral and jewel. Its gravel is pearl, coral and jewel. Allah Akbar. Its construction is made of silver and gold bricks. As for its rivers, some are made of water, whose taste and smell never change. Some are made of milk, whose taste never change. Some are made of delicious wine that we are deprived of in this life. Wine, while others are made of pure honey. The food of the people of paradise shall be the fruits of the and the flesh of fowls. Their drinks shall be ginger and camphor. Their dishes shall be made of pure gold and silver. Their garments shall be made of silk and gold. Their couches where they sit and lie and rest will be lined with silk brocade of the highest sort. Their faces shall be as handsome and as comely as the full moon, and they will be in the age like the men of 30 years old in the shape of Adam alayhi salam, the father of mankind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Brethren in Islam, celebrating this Eid is meant for those who have fasted, those who have observed Qiyam al-Layl, the night prayers, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is meant for those whose hearts are brightened by the light of Iman, of faith, and purified from sins and the snares of shaitan, the traps of the shaitan. The Muslim's Eid is an occasion for eliminating rancor and hatred, for overpowering the satanic or shaitan instilled feelings and sentiments, and for conquering those sentiments that have divided the Muslim nation and damaged their brother. Let us make, brothers and sisters in Islam, a real turning point in our relationship with our relatives, with our neighbors, with our brothers and sisters in Islam. Let us transcend mere outward appearance and rituals in our Eid so that it can be a prosperous one for all. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُبِ وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ مَنْ كَانَ مُخْتَالًا فَخُورًا. Worship Allah. Enjoy none in worship with Him. Do no shirk. The companion by your side, the wayfarer, the traveler whom you meet, and those slaves from your right hand you possess. Verily Allah does not like such as proud boastful. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا كما أمر، واشكره له الكفيل بالزيادة لمن شكر، واشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يرغب لمن جحد به وكفر، واشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to preach the women on the day of Eid just as he would address them. Dear sisters in Islam, your ancestors, the great women of Islam, were one of the main reasons for this great nation to take a great place amongst all other nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who granted this nation, that who granted Islam to this ummah, made a high place for the Muslim woman and decreed that they share the responsibilities of enjoying truth, forbidding evil, and raising the flag of Islam. He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة ويطيعون الله ورسوله أولئك سيرحمهم الله إن الله عزيز حكيم. The believers, men and the women, are loyalists of one another. They enjoin righteousness and they forbid the evil. They offer the salah perfectly and they give the zakah and they obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah will leave His mercy on them, His rahmah. Surely Allah is Almighty, all wise. Sisters in Islam, be proud of your deen and the religion of your ancestors, Islam. Be a good example for your sons and daughters and sincere in your belonging to this ummah. Know that the hijab in its true sense, from head to toe, is an honor. It is an honor to all wise people. And that adultery is dishonorable to all nations, even if some may call it freedom. Know that adultery is also done with the eyes by seeing, with the ears by listening, with the mouth, as was mentioned in a hadith related by Imam Muslim. Your happiness, sisters in Islam, is in being an obedient and believing daughter, a loyal and generous wife, and a pious and merciful mother. Know that prayer is the cornerstone of Islam. Fasting one day for the sake of Allah takes your face 70 years away from the hellfire, as in the hadith related to us by Al-Bukhari Muslim. Charity, the sadaqah, is a major cause for gaining forgiveness and for repentance to be accepted. Those women who are showing part of their body to the men in public will not enter paradise or smell its fragrance and are cursed, as in the hadith related by Imam Muslim. Hijab is an honor and protection for you. Hijab must be modest in color and not exotic, wide and thick, not revealing. different from the deaths of non-Muslim women and men. عباد الله إن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ألا وصلوا على من أمركم ربكم بالصلاة عليه فقال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد ورضى الله عن الأربعة الخلفاء الأئمة الحنفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعيهم اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا سخاء رخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا اللهم اجعلنا ممن قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا واجعلنا ممن صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا واجعلنا ممن قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا يا رب العالمين ربنا إننا ظلمنا أنفسنا ظلما كثيرا ولا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت فاغفر لنا مغفرة من عندك وقنا عذاب النار يا رب العالمين ربنا أكرم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واجعلنا من الذين تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم الحمد لله رب العالمين
Tapos na ang ating alhamdulillah sa pagkakitsuka, tapos na rin. Ngayon, pwede ka ma-invest. Huwag muna tayong maalis. If you wish to witness yung ating mga anak na nanawag sa competition, just stay around. Sa mga babae, you can also do it. We are just going to get the prizes now. And inshallah, it will be useful for all of us to do it.
We will share food, but we have to serve food. And Rahman will eat the prices. Where are the prices? Please.